MotorWeek is made possible by TireRack.com, RockAuto.com, State Farm, and WeatherTech.
Here's something that's rapidly going away, the old-fashioned key and the two-button key fob. These things are being replaced by modern keys that, well, they don't fit into anything. These things, they go in your pocket and they send out a signal so that you can touch the door handle and unlock the car, or lock it for that matter. Stays in your pocket, you get into the car, put your foot on the brake, touch a button on the dash or on the console, the car starts. Pretty neat. But all of these things, as nice as they are, they have a downside. What do you do if the battery in the car is dead or the battery in the key fob is dead? Well, the first thing you should have done before the inevitable happens is you should have read the owner's manual to see what you do. In this particular case, the key fob is designed in such a manner that you pry the lid off of it, and here inside we have a little key. That little mechanical key goes into the opening in the door and you unlock it, and that way you can get into the car. Okay, that's fine. But not all cars have an exposed lock such as this one does. Now, the other thing is that many of these things will be hidden. You'll find that it may be backed by the license plate, the tag, whatever you call it, and it may be have a cover over it. You have to pry the cover off, being careful not to scratch the paint, and all these different procedures. You have to know what is proper for your car. And some people, you may have a Ford that has something like this car has with the keypad on the door. Well, if the battery's dead in the car, that doesn't help you any because it doesn't work. Now, the other thing is, what do you do if the key, the battery in it, goes dead? Well, you still have to know how to get into the car. And then once inside the car, you have to know what to do with this key. Because some of them you'll hold up against the side of the steering column and push the start button. Others you'll lay them in one of the cup holders. Still others you may put it into a receptacle in the console, and there's all kinds of different configurations for these things. So you have to know which one is right for your car. So when the inevitable happens, you know what to do. And if you have a question or comment, drop me a line right here at MotorWeek.